Mesopotamian civilization is one of the oldest civilization in the world, contemporary to Mesopotamian civilization, Egyptian civilization, Chinese, Nile, these all. The Indus Valley civilization is also called the Harappan culture. What do you mean by culture? Why we call it culture? Archaeologists use the term culture for a group of objects, objects distinctive in style, that are usually found together within specific geographical area and period of time, which we obtained, which archaeologists they found in certain regions of Harappan sites. In the case of the Harappan culture, these distinctive objects include seals that they found, beads, weights, stone plates, and even baked bricks. These objects were found from areas as far apart as not only in India, but also from Pakistan, from Afghanistan. Next one is, why is the civilization which developed on the banks of River Indus and its tributaries known as the Harappan civilization? Why we call it Harappan civilization? Why not only Indus Valley civilization? Answer is here. The Indus Valley civilization is also known as the Harappan civilization because it was the first city. It was the first city which discovered by archaeologists in India. That's why we call this civilization Harappan civilization. It was a Bronze Age civilization. Indus Valley civilization dated between this was the period when this civilization was flourished in India, 2600 BC to 1900 BCE. This period is also known as the mature Harappan culture. Now this whole Harappan civilization is divided into three ages. First one, a unique feature of civilization was development of urban centers as early as 2600 BCE. It means 2600 BCE when urban centers have started coming up, we keep this particular period in mature Harappan period. Before this, we have early Harappan period, 3500 to 2700 BC, and then we have later Harappan period from 1900 to 1500 BC. This was the period when almost Harappan civilization was declined, and some cities or some places were only left of this civilization. Aryans have come up in India and new towns started coming up in rest of the part and especially Ganga Valley. Map showing some mature Harappan sites. You can see this map. Chamdaro is there, Dholavira is there, Nageshwar is there, Mohanjodaro is here, Kodbisi is here. These all are Banavali, Rakhigad, Harappa. These all were important cities of Indus Valley civilization. A unique feature of the civilization was development of urban centers in as early as 2600, and that's why I told you we kept this period in mature Harappan period, mature Harappan civilization. Mohenjo-daro, a planned urban center. Cities of Indus Valley civilization, IVC stands for Indus Valley civilization, were well planned. Main features of Mohenjo-daro, you can see here three. Settlement were divided into two sections, citadel, upper town and lower town. The citadel was walled and separated from the lower town was also walled. Bricks used in building the city's houses were of standardized ratio. This is very important, unique feature of entire civilization in all cities. Roads in the cities were laid out along a grid pattern intersecting each other at right angles and both the side proper drainage system, proper plantation, as we have today in modern cities. Now, drainage system is a very important question and topic to discuss. Drainage system of Indus Valley civilization. The plant drainage system was one of the most distinctive features of Harappan cities. Historians believe that streets with drains were laid out first and then houses were built along them. Some features of drainage system, now you can see here three features of drainage system. First one, every house was connected to the street drain. This was important. House drains imparted themselves into the main drain as we have today. The drainage system and drains were covered with bricks and or stones that we are doing today also. They were provided with inspection holes at regular intervals for cleaning. House drains first imparted into sumps into which solid matter settled and waste water flowed into the street drain so that it cannot be choked. Flow will remain, should remain continue. So this is a map of Mohenjo-daro. You can see here how this city was planned and built. Next one, domestic architecture. In domestic architecture, you can see that what type of architecture was there in citadel, in upper town. It is one of citadel that structures used for special public purposes were built. The great baths, very important question. Very unique feature of Harappan civilization. This structure we found, archaeologists, they found in Mohenjo-daro, the great bath, public bath. It was a large rectangular tank surrounded by corridors on all four sides. There were two flights of stairs on opposite sides. Leakage of water from the tanks was probably prevented by making a mortar or of gypsum. There were rooms on three sides and water from the tank flowed into a huge drain. If you see today our swimming pools, how we have them, how we have our changing rooms, how we have corridors to sit around, these all were present at that time in great bath. What was the purpose of making it? That's not clear. Some they say for maybe for any special occasion or for to take the ritual bath or something like that. But it's not clear for what objective, for what purpose they had, they built such structure. This is our great bath. Now, subsistence strategies. How they were procuring foods, how they were obtaining livelihood, how they were obtaining resources for their survival. Here you see the Harappan consumed various plant and animal products including fish. They consumed grains such as wheat, lentil, chickpea, sesame, millets. Charred particles of these grains have been found at various Harappan sites. Bones of animals such as boar, deer, alligator have been found. Bones of fish, fowl have also been found. So we can say that they were consuming these all animals as well as they were cultivating certain cereals. Agricultural technologies. What was their technology, their method of doing agriculture? What we know, Harappans practiced agriculture, that is clear, we know. Oxen were used for ploughing land, that also we know, we have evidences. What we do not know, actual agricultural practices Still not clear. Tools used for cultivating fields. Stone tools, metal tools, or what objects? It's not clear. See this picture? Now, some facts about Harappan sites. Harappan sites are located in semi-arid regions, so fields were perhaps irrigated. Located in semi-arid regions, so all settlements were not on fertile lands. Some were far away from arid regions, semi-arid regions. How they were doing agriculture over there? They had canals through which they were transporting water, taking it to fields. Traces of canals have been found at Sorthughai in Afghanistan, but not in Punjab and Sindh. Water from wells may have been used for cultivating lands. Water reservoirs at Dholaviram may have been used to store water for agriculture.